Right, now the front end's mostly done. I'm going to deal with those the fact the tyres keep losing pressure. I'm sticking some of this stuff in. Linseal. I swear by this stuff. I use it on the big bike there and the lawn tractor, as well as wheelbarrows and stuff. Wheelbarrows and sack trucks. It really does what it's supposed to. It seals them. If you've got existing punctures, and like if you get pick up any fresh punches with nails or anything like that, it will seal them for that. Stops your tyres going down. So this recommends ATV 1 litre, but this is like just half a litre left in this bottle, so I'm going to put the 250ml in each of the front tyres. It's quite expensive, this stuff, but I think it's worth every penny for off-road vehicles. And so first thing you want to do is just make sure your tyre valve's just above the half, around about 3/4 the high top, and then you pull the cap off. The cap actually comes with a tool to remove the valve, but I've got one anyway. So just unscrew the valve. I've got gloves on because this stuff, it can be quite messy. So that's the valve out. And then we basically do is just stick this over there and squeeze the bottle till the required amount is in there. Wipe it down and play it as normal. And that should seal any leaks in that. So just repeat that with the other side. Right, now that that's front end done, I think I'm going to put the plastics back on there. Now I've still not sorted the headlight issue, but I think I've got to work around just by swapping some wires around in the switch, so I don't need the plastics off to do that. So I'll put the front plastics on, and then I've got some work to do on the rear, and then I'll put those plastics back on. Right, so that's the tank, and then the fender's on. So next is just that front bit there, and the light fastens on. That's actually got a crack in it. You see, just let's see there. So what I'm going to do is just going to use my soldering iron, just heating up there. So I'm just going to plastic weld it from the back, so when it gets pulled in, this front looks kind of neat. You see, yeah, doesn't stand out quite as much. We're just trying to bond this together a bit. Yeah, I'll leave it at that. You see, you can still see the crack there, but it's not all sprung, which is what I want. So now I'll throw this back on. Right, so that's all the plastics I can put back on for now. So I've got a few more things, the rear brake cable to do, and the brake, the handbrake sort of lock that goes on the rear brake as well. So that fastens on here, so I'll not put the other panels on just yet, wherever they are, lost them. But yeah, it's now running. Still to do that front light, and I'm going to also see if I can make this a bit shinier using the old half and half white spirit and the linseed oil. Let's see if it works. But yeah, looking good just now. I'll probably give it a rest for today and come back tomorrow and do brakes or rear brakes.